ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂട്ട് ടൈറ്റാനിയത്തിന്റെ സ്ഥാപനങ്ങൾ ഇതൊന്നും ഒരു രാഷ്ട്രീയക്കാരന്റെ സ്വപ്നങ്ങളല്ല പക്ഷേ കേരളത്തിലെ കേരളത്തെ സ്നേഹിക്കുന്ന ഒരു പ്രതിരോധ വകുപ്പ് ശാസ്ത്രജ്ഞന്റെ ആഗ്രഹങ്ങളാണ് ഫ്രൈഡേ എഡിഷനിൽ നമ്മോടൊപ്പം ഡോക്ടർ എ ശിവതാണുപിള്ളെ സിഇഒ ബ്രഹ്മോസ് എയ്റോസ്പേസ് ഡോക്ടർ പിള്ളെ താങ്ക്സ് ഫോർ ജോയിനിങ് അസ് ഓൺ ദ ഫ്രൈഡേ എഡിഷൻ ബ്രഹ്മോസ് എയ്റോസ്പേസ് കേരളത്തിലുണ്ട് ഇൻഡോ റഷ്യൻ പ്രോജക്ട് എന്നുള്ള രീതിയിൽ ലോകം മുഴുവൻ അറിയപ്പെടുന്നതാണ് ബ്രഹ്മോസ് എയ്റോസ്പേസ് ഇന്ന് ബ്രഹ്മോസ് മിസൈൽ എവിടെ എത്തി നിൽക്കുന്നു
ബ്രഹ്മോസ് ആസ് യു നോ ഇസ് എ സൂപ്പർസോണിക് ക്രൂയിസ് മിസൈൽ ടുഡേ വേൾഡ് ഓവർ വെൻ ദ പീപ്പിൾ ഹവ് ഗോൺ ഫോർ ക്രൂയിസ് മിസൈൽ ടെക്നോളജി ദേ ഹവ് ഗോൺ ഫോർ സബ്സോണിക് സ്പീഡ് സോ വി ആർ ദ ഫസ്റ്റ് ടു അറ്റംപ്റ്റ് ദി ടു മേക്ക് ദി ഫാസ്റ്റസ്റ്റ് മിസൈൽ വിച്ച് ക്യാൻ നോട്ട് ഓൺലി ഫ്ലൈ ഫാസ്റ്റർ it can defeat any enemy's target with precision so speed precision and power we have overtaken others through this program it is an effort of india and russia together and putting together the technologies developed in both the nations as you know we have developed space technology in a big way we are one of the space powers in the world today and we have developed a missile Agni and Padvi systems are already in service as a strategic system. So during these developments, there are many new aerospace technologies have been developed in this country. That gave us strength to go for a joint venture, which helped us to make this type of missile. It has been inducted in the Indian Navy in a number of warships. It has been inducted by the Indian Army. 1st Regiment is already in operation. And recently we have got orders from the both Indian Army and Indian Air Force for the inducting.
അപ്പോൾ ഈ പ്രത്യേക മിസൈൽ എയർ ഫോഴ്സിന്റെ ആവശ്യം ഉണ്ടായിരിക്കും.
You know, like the Navy is using this missile against ships, warships. That the war theater is the ocean. Now when the Army fires the missile, they go move to the border and they fire this type of missiles. against the army targets so that the army to army fight they take care of
okay
but at the same time there are airfields and other type of targets which are relevant to the air force so those targets will be aimed by the air force even they can be behind and fire it
ee rand order etra oru nammude oru volume economic volume financial volume parayanengil etra rupayude order undu idu rendum koodi
the recent order which we have got is 11600 crores for raising two regiments for the army and one squadron for the air force
so this makes brahmos a very different project from the other indigenous missile projects which drdo has been trying to develop what is the secret behind the success of brahmos
I would like to tell four factors one is that this project being a joint venture there is concerted effort between the two sides Two sides means you know the both the sides wanting to see that we win.
That is India and Russia.
India and Russia. This is one of the very important things. Second thing is because of the close association with the Russian scientists, we are able to get the latest technologies from them also. So the input on the technology, input on the review system, how to make a quality product and make it operationalized. This helped us. To realize it faster in an operational mode. Second, third important factor is, from the day one, the industries have come forward in a big way to invest by themselves to create facilities which will enable production. So we have not taken any time between development and production. We have dovetailed the whole thing inside. That's how we are able to produce. This is the third factor. The fourth important factor is, there is a friendship between these two countries there is a belief between these two countries which made to the heads of the two organizations to constantly review and support us for example when president putin now prime minister putin he has got a personal interest to see that this joint venture succeeds similarly our prime minister takes lot of interest in understanding the you know requirements and trying to give the full support.
So now that you have got an order for 11,600 crores for this, what component of that order would be developed or made or fabricated in Kerala?
Let me put it like this. We started as a company with an investment of total $300 million as a joint venture between the two countries. But if you look at our orders, we already crossed nearly 3.5 to 4 billion dollar worth of orders. This itself is a big jump in terms of business. Now, when we take a business, we have to share the business between partners, and we have to share the work among the industries in India. So one thing is how much we should use the Russian industries. That is one question. Second thing is all based on the time and the deliveries, we have to look at it. Second thing, in the India itself, we have developed a number of industries. We are a late player as far as the Trivandrum unit is concerned. The Caltech unit, which was there, they were doing a good job for the space program. Nearly 80% of their effort is for space program. But now, when after we have taken over that unit, we are trying to increase the content for the defense. Now, when we are increasing, they are picking up that one at a later phase compared to the other industries. But they have got a preferential treatment they have, because they are unit of the BrahMos. So that is how, particularly for the Air Force requirements, we have given the jobs to them first, because they are new, like Air Force, the launcher, very critical component for holding the missile.
പ്രദേശത്തിലേക്ക് വീണ്ടും സ്വാഗതം. സർ, ഇപ്പൊ താങ്കൾ പറഞ്ഞു 12,000 കോടിയുടെ ഓർഡർ, 12,000 കോടിക്ക് അടുത്തുള്ള ഓർഡർ വരുമ്പോൾ കേരളത്തിലാകും അതിന്റെ എയർഫോഴ്സ് കോമ്പോണന്റിന്റെ ലോഞ്ചർ, സുഖോയിൽ നിന്നുള്ള ലോഞ്ചർ ഒക്കെ വികസിപ്പിക്കുന്നത്. കേരളത്തിലെ പ്രൈവറ്റ് ഇൻഡസ്ട്രിക്ക് ഇതുകൊണ്ട് എന്ത് ഗുണമുണ്ടാവും? ആക്സിലറി ഇൻഡസ്ട്രീസ്,
ട്രൂ, there are a number of units which have been developed during the space program. Basically, the VSSC, all units of important units of space, they are in Trivandrum, around Trivandrum, Valiyamala, that place. Then we have got the Caltech, which was formed by the people who have come out of ISRO. So there is definitely a thrust for aerospace manufacturing around Trivandrum, and I have seen around Caltech itself, there are a number of units have come, formed by the Caltech people themselves. So there is definitely a capacity build-up which has taken place. Now we should utilize these capacities.
So this will automatically give more opportunities.
So what we have done now, when we have taken over the Caltech as BATL, we have seen, we have plotted what are the industries which can support us in Kerala. And we have evaluated them through our Missile System Quality Assurance Agency to certify these industries also can work for us. So today there are 8 types of systems which have been given to the BrahMos Trivandrum unit for production for the against army unit. They are now being distributed to these units as their sub. We are trying to create a network of industries which can support us from Kerala itself.
That's why I asked you, would it automatically give or create more job opportunities in Kerala?
I cannot clearly answer to this, because the industries whom we are referring to, they are already almost established industries. One is on the mechanical fabrication, other one is on the electronics. But where the augmentation of manpower will happen is when the BrahMos unit comes for integration of the missile and deliver it. So we are now going to establish, our government of India has funded rupees 50 crores to establish a new facility which will do the integration of the BrahMos missiles.
In Kerala?
In Trivandrum. So if that happens, then you need specialized manpower. So there will be augmentation of manpower in that unit.
ഈ തിരുവനന്തപുരത്തിനോടും കേരളത്തിനോടുള്ള സ്നേഹം താങ്കൾ കന്യാകുമാരി ജില്ലയിൽ ജനിച്ചു എന്നത് കൊണ്ട് മാത്രമാണോ?
അങ്ങനല്ല. ഫസ്റ്റ് ആദ്യമായിട്ട് ഞാൻ സാറാഭായി കണ്ടപ്പോൾ അത് സ്പേസിൽ ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റ് ഉണ്ടായി. അപ്പോൾ സ്പേസ് റിസർച്ച് ട്രിവാൻഡ്രം യൂണിറ്റിൽ ആദ്യം ഫസ്റ്റ് ജോബ് ഐ ഗോട്ട് ഇറ്റ് ഇൻ
വി എസ് എസ്.
So there I was groomed, and I worked with Vikram Sarabhai, Professor Satish Dhawan, and Dr. Abdul Kalam. Abdul Kalam, I worked with him for a long time in the SLV3 project. So that gave me the base to have attachment to the Trivandrum. Then my first house I constructed in Trivandrum. So I have become a permanent
person.
So you are
an adopted son of Kerala.
Kerala, yes. And my wife is born in Trivandrum. So there was so much of link. And I was born in Trivandrum state, which is part of Trivandrum is part of the Trivandrum was the capital of the Trivandrum state.
At what stage is the phase two of Brahmos in Trivandrum?
See, our main hitch was the availability of land. We got funds, we got plans, we were ready to do it. I want to do it very fast. We have got some people trained at Hyderabad to take over the job at Trivandrum. Now when we have groomed everything, that land has to come to us. That land is owned by the Indian Air Force. They agreed to give the land, provided we give a suitable replacement area to them.
That
nearby.
Is a small area, right?
Yeah, but seven acres.
Only 7 acres.
7 acres. So we agreed to do that. We did survey. We identified some places. Kerala government industry department took a lot of interest to do that. But we were not able to converge. Some land which is identified was under airport authority. Then we talked to airport authority. They agreed to give. But that land could not be acquired in time. So there is some problem with that. So like this it was going on. But recently some solution has been added.
What is the solution?
Solution is that in one of the nearby land, the Kerala government announced as a surplus land for, they say land bank they created. Out of that we told Air Force, you please go and see and select it. So they are doing the survey. But the main thing is that land need to be developed. So the Industries Department said, we will develop and give it to you. We will see that the whole area is filled with new type of soil, water supply is provided, all those things they have talked
so
about.
When do you hope? When is your deadline?
I think in another 2 months we will start the work.
Oh, so before Onam your second phase would be?
Yes, exactly. No, that work will start. But we need to construct. I expect 1.5 years it will take to construct the whole facility. And surely we will accelerate.
So what is what would be the number of missiles integrated here, or the turnover you expect out of the Kerala facility?
We are making the components at different places, so all the things will not be made in Trivandrum. It will come from.
But integration will happen in Trivandrum.
So we will do the integration line, and our aim is to make at least 2 missiles per month. Integration should come out. That means about 24 to 25 missiles should be the turnover from this plant. This is what we are aiming at.
Sir, there are one or two Kerala thina kurichulla presentations vaayikkanum kaanuvan idayirunnu. Adhil Kerala thinte oro bhagathinum pratheekamaya reethiyil valarthaavunna allengil investment possible aayittulla defense establishment ne kurichu prathipadichittundu. Adaanu Kochiyile oru electronic park, Palakkad oru nano biopharma possibility ne kurichokka parayunnu. പാലക്കാട് പോലൊരു സ്ഥലത്ത് എങ്ങനെയാണ് ഒരു ഹെർബൽ ഗാർഡൻ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അത്തരത്തിൽ നാനോ ബയോ പോസിബിലിറ്റി എങ്ങനെയാണ് അവിടെ സാധ്യമാവുക?
ബിഫോർ ആൻസറിംഗ് ദാറ്റ് ഐ വുഡ് ലൈക്ക് ടു ടെൽ യു ദിസ് ബ്രഹ്മോസ് എസ്റ്റാബ്ലിഷ്മെന്റ് അറ്റ് ട്രിവാൻഡ്രം ബികെയിം ദ കൈനീട്ടം ഫോർ ന്യൂ ഡിഫൻസ് എസ്റ്റാബ്ലിഷ്മെന്റ്സ് ടു കം ടു കേരള ദെൻ സബ്സിക്വന്റ്ലി വി ഹാവ് സീൻ എച്ച് എൽ coming up, then the BEML putting up a plant, BEL in Cochin district. Like that things have come now. Now we have got 4 or 5 defense units are visible in Kerala. This is a big change, and the credit goes to Mr. Antony, the defense minister, and the industry minister, Mr. Karim. They worked together jointly to see that Kerala industrial
development. They set an example on how two politicians.
Mr. Karim has got, as an industry minister, he organized seminars where we could present various views of how Kerala can come up. When I studied Kerala, I found 2-3 things. One is the Kerala has got the best intelligent manpower. But that manpower, if it is channelized and focused into an effort, they will be the best people to turn out Kerala to
we'll
a golden state.
We'll come into the details after a break. Or it available again. സ്റ്റഡി എഡിഷനിലേക്ക് വീണ്ടും സ്വാഗതം. കേരളത്തിന്റെ മാൻ പവർ, യു സെഡ് ഇഫ് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ട്രെയിൻഡ് പ്രോപ്പർലി, സോ വേർ ഡു വി ലാക്ക്? വാട്ട് ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് ട്രെയിനിങ് ഡു വി ലാക്ക് ഇൻ?
ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ, സ്കിൽ, നോബഡി ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് ദ സ്കിൽ. ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് മെയിൻലി ദ ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ്. സോ ദ ട്രെയിനിങ് ഈസ് ഇൻ ദ ഫോം ഓഫ് ഫോക്കസിംഗ് ദ എഫേർട്ട് ടു പ്രൊഡക്ഷൻ, ഫോക്കസ് ദി എഫേർട്ട് ടു കോൺട്രിബ്യൂട്ട് ഇൻ ടു സം സെറ്റ് ഓഫ് an output which will may turn out this place into a golden place. Today the Kerala contributes maximum foreign exchange to India today, and the people who are outside Kerala, we are amazed to see their performance. Then why not the same people in Kerala perform better? This is the question. Now if you have got a good center like Vikram Sarabhai Space Center, I have seen people from Kerala working there. Their output is good. NPOL DRDO, they are doing fantastic work. So that means if you have got an organization which is bound and more focused on deliveries, then the output will be better. This is what we are trying to do it in the BrahMos complex in Trivandrum. If that experiment succeeds, I will tell you this God's own country will be the best state, industrial state in
India. We have no doubts on that. Now, you have not answered an earlier question which I asked.
Okay. Let me tell you that. See, you take titanium raw material, plenty available in Kerala. The Kerala sand is not sand. You take sand, 65% of the sand consists of different types of minerals. We have thorium, we have got magnesite, we have got titanium raw material. Where else you get it? Tsunami came, but it brought more thorium and more titanium materials. But are we utilizing that resource? That's the question. So that is why in the industry department vision, I have presented, you have got all resources. When we say Palakkad, that the whole Silent Valley area, if you take, the best herbal plants are there. There are 800 special species of plants are available in Kerala. Are we deploying that? No. So herbal as a raw input, sand from sand, thorium and the titanium as raw input, intelligent manpower, why not we succeed? Raw material, manpower, and once it is good, investment will take place. So it is the Kerala people should understand this and they should rise to this.
Is there any restriction in an NRA investing in the defense sector? Can he invest like any other private player?
Today there are so many private industries who are participating in the defense. There's no restriction on that. The NRI can start an industry, and there are industries put by NRI. And we have seen some of the best electronic connectors and electronic units are made by the NRIs in Kerala itself.
So you mean to say that there is a lack of, or an awareness is not being inculcated among Keralites about its possibilities?
No, they are becoming more individualistic than state-oriented. That's a problem we are seeing. They raise various forms of their rights rather than doing things. So this is the conflict we have. And once we settle down this and change the attitude and everybody focused on mission-oriented programs, I will tell you, this will be the best place.
But that has always been the paradox. Yes. That has always been a point of discussion throughout Kerala.
But I see a change. When we have introduced this program in our BrahMos complex, I have seen a change. The people who were part of the unions, they have come out of the unions. Mm. They said, we don't want a union. Today there is no union in BrahMos Aerospace complex. They are able to work with us as a welfare committee members, trying to raise their issues, discuss and then find solutions. So I find the people, once they know that this is the way we have to work and produce output and make the organization great, they will do it. Example is BrahMos complex in Trivandrum.
Dr. Pillai, thank you very much for joining us on the Friday edition.
Thank you.
Keralathinu pogan valareyara dooranglundu. Cheriyoru മൈൻഡ് സെറ്റിൽ വന്ന ചെറിയൊരു മാറ്റം മാത്രം മതി കേരളം കുതിച്ചുയരാൻ എന്നാണ് ഒരു സ്പേസ് സയന്റിസ്റ്റ്, അതേപോലെ തന്നെ ഒരു ഡിഫൻസ് മേഖലയിലും ഡിസ്റ്റിംഗ്വിഷ്ഡ് സയന്റിസ്റ്റ് എന്ന് ഇന്ത്യ ഗവൺമെന്റ് ആദരിച്ച ഡോക്ടർ ശിവതാണുപിള്ളയുടെ അഭിപ്രായം. ശിവതാണുപിള്ളയ്ക്കൊപ്പം കേരളത്തിന്റെ നല്ല നാളേക്ക് വേണ്ടി പ്രതീക്ഷകൾ കൈമാറിക്കൊണ്ട് ഫ്രൈഡേഷൻ സമാപിക്കുന്നു. അടുത്ത ആഴ്ച വീണ്ടും കാണാം. നമസ്കാരം.